It's almost time for the new year. So before we enter the new year, you'll want to be sure you have some sort of system together for bookkeeping for small business. So here's how I stay on top of my bookkeeping and reasons why bookkeeping is important for your small business, plus some bookkeeping software options.
She's an icon, she's a legend, and she is the moment. Now come on now.
What's up, icons? It's the iconic fashion figure back with a new video. And back in 2020, I used to struggle with staying on top of my bookkeeping. I think I've mentioned it to you guys before. So 2021, I promised myself I was going to find the right system for my bookkeeping. And I must say, I did pretty well this year. So first, I ordered these bins, I believe off of Michael's for like $3 or $5. They were super cheap, they were on clearance, and I got a whole box of them. I have it in a specific order. So first I have it started where my orders that I receive in are in order by month. So each month has a different file for the orders that I receive. I always print out my orders because it's needed for the operations process from the moment the order is received until it's actually shipped out the door. So I have to have it printed. Plus I write on orders and everything too. And then once that is done, it gets filed in here by month. And then that way at the end of every month, when I'm doing my analyzing and trying to see how I've done for the month, I can look at the system to see my profits for the month. But if something seems off, I have all the paperwork here. Then I have another folder in here. Actually, I should say folders because, again, by month with expenses. So I have a log for every month on my expenses. Actually, before I even get to this on the expenses, I have a separate file organizer over here, which you guys can't see in the footage, but I'll insert a picture that I bought from IKEA. I believe that was $20 from IKEA, and it has 5 slots on there. And on that organizer is pretty much all the documents I need to file into here. I usually don't get to filing right away. I find a specific time to actually get to my filing, so that organizer helps me to keep it organized so that my filing is quick. So in that organizer, I have a slot for my orders that need to be filed once they are shipped. I have a slot in there for receipts, so any hard copy receipts that are printed out goes into there so that I can log them in and file them by month. First, I log them on my computer so that way it's in my accounting system, and then it gets filed in here. Then I have another slot for invoices, so any invoices that I had to pay out something, that's technically another expense. I just separate it from like my shopping expenses versus like my invoices when I'm paying the factories for inventory expenses. So those are separate in that file slot. And then I have like a miscellaneous category, and then like the top slot is like my paperwork for new collections and stuff like that. But in there I have 3 different slots of paperwork that needs to be filed. Once I go through this, I usually do my accounting at the beginning of every month, basically for the previous month. I'll go through each of those slots, enter it in on my computer if it needs to be entered, like receipts, and then file it over here. So for expenses, once I get to this file folder, I have it by month, and at the beginning of every month in its folder, I have an expense sheet, and this is where I log it in. Now, I do accounting and bookkeeping on my computer so I can have it digitally, but I still have the manual paperwork, and I'll explain why in a moment, why I'm kind of like doubling up on the same information. But it gets filed in here, logged in on the expense sheet, and then at the end of the month I can tally up, you know, how much I spent for that month. And then that is one of the reasons why I do it digitally and manually, because maybe I forgot to enter something in my system and it just got filed. So it's checks and balances. I can look on my computer and see what my total expenses were for that month on the computer, and then make sure it matches what I logged manually. If the numbers are different, that's when I can print out my report from my computer, plus pull my log from this folder along with any receipts or invoices that are with it, and see where I messed up. See if it's the computer that's wrong, or is it something in my log that is wrong. And then the other thing that's filed in here is my mileage reports. So any mileage, any traveling, anything like that I do, I also have a log for that, and I log it in here. So that folder is pretty much just a log to log it in. There's really nothing to actually put in there, but I do have a folder for that just so I can keep track of mileage. And then the last folder in here is like any contracts or agreements that I signed, or like let's say model agreements. If I have those, I'll log them in here for that year as well, because then at the end of the year I use this entire file bin This is not what gets filed for taxes. That is the other reason I do everything manually too, because I can just pull this and I could also print the reports from my computer as well. And again, checks and balances. Make sure everything is matching up so that way I don't miss anything come tax time or I don't file anything that's incorrect, because Lord knows I don't want to have to do an amendment for my taxes. So that's another reason for me going manually. Plus, you always want to try to keep your receipts and things like that when filing taxes, because you never know if you're going to get audited, then the IRS is going to be asking for copies of everything. And that leads me to the next step. So once my taxes is filed, this year is pretty much done. So like right now, I can't even lift it, it's too much stuff in there. But I would take out 2020. Let's just say this is 2020 right here. I would rubber band all of that together to make sure that year stays together. And then I have a separate filing system in a closet that I keep all the different years bundled together. And I try to keep the last few years, at least the last three, just because the IRS can go back at any time they want. So I do keep them. They don't stay in these individual folders. Once the year is done, I just pull everything out and either rubber band it together if it's too much paperwork, or use those binder clips. So binder clips like these, except the bigger ones. These are the little mini ones. So that's pretty much my system that's been working for me this year so far. As far as the software that I use in my computer, I have a built-in software in my system, so it's not even one that I can recommend or tell you to go download, but I can give you some options of some. So you can use options like QuickBooks and Wave. I've shown you guys, I believe in another video, QuickBooks that you can use for small businesses. Wave is free if you want to try Wave as well. I've never personally tried it, but I've heard good feedback about it. But I'll go ahead and find the video I originally did as far as your accounting and bookkeeping and link that somewhere either up here or in the description box. You guys can check out the other software options, because I'm almost positive I've already done that. If not, and if you don't have the time to check out the other video, just look into QuickBooks and look into Wave. So the main reasons you want to make sure to stay on top of your bookkeeping, I know this topic is boring and most of the time you guys don't pay attention to me when I talk about stuff like this, because you're just focused on, you know, getting started and getting your inventory. But I promise you, this is information you want to know before jumping into business, because this is a major part of running a business. So one of the main reasons for bookkeeping is, of course, to stay organized when it comes to tax season. Tax season is already a headache in its own, especially when you have to file business taxes. So you want to stay organized throughout the entire year on your bookkeeping, so that way it makes tax season a lot easier for you. Bookkeeping also helps you keep track of your profit and loss. So like I showed you guys, I keep track of my sales for every month. I keep track of my expenses for every month, so that way I can see, did I actually make money or did I lose money? Am I spending too much money? That leads me into the third reason. With this is how you can see where you're spending too much money if you are. So if you're looking at your profit and loss statements and you're noticing that your expenses are higher than your profit, one of the first things you'll do in that situation is look at your profit margin, make sure it's high enough so that way you can actually run your business off of the profit margin that you have on your product or your service. But then you also want to look at where you're spending your money at. So when you have it organized by file, by month, you want to look to see, where is your money going to? Maybe there's areas you can cut back on and that's why you're not making a profit. You might be spending too much in a certain area. Maybe you're spending too much on inventory. Maybe it's too much on supplies. Maybe you need to cut back on the traveling. When you keep track of your bookkeeping, it's easy to look at, you know, your profit and loss and then see where you're spending too much money at or where you're not making enough money, because that could be a problem too. So the best tips I can give you for bookkeeping, number one, which you guys have heard me say multiple times, keep business and personal completely separate. It's easier to analyze your business when you don't have your personal expenses involved as well. When you start including personal and business, it makes it so much harder to analyze. When it comes to tax time, it makes that harder. Keep all of it separate. I've already said this in the video, but tip number two is to keep track of your bookkeeping year round. Don't wait till December and don't wait till tax season to try to pull all this together. It's frustrating, it's aggravating, it's annoying. You don't want to do that to yourself. If you keep track of it year round, tax season is so much easier. And then tip number three, organize everything by category. So you guys notice I kept my sales and my expenses completely separate. Those were in separate folders. So that's one way to organize. But diving deeper into that, when it comes to my expenses, I organize those by category. That's the point of my log, because it makes it easier for me to categorize every one of my expenses. And when I say organize it by category, I mean like your inventory is one category, supplies another category, equipment another category, rent utilities another category, travel expenses another category. Like, there's a bunch of different categories. And the reason being, one, when you're analyzing to figure out where you're spending too much money, you can look at those categories and see where you can cut back if your expenses are too high. And then two, when it comes to filing taxes, you usually file those deductions that way. They do it by category. If you already have it organized by category, it only makes it easier for you come tax time when you have to file, because it's already organized by category. And if you have an accountant or CPA, trust me, they're going to thank you for doing that for them. So if you can organize by category, that is always very helpful. So again, I know this topic can be very boring, but it is important when you're running a business. So if you've already started your business, this is definitely something to pay attention to now. Don't wait until it's too late. Take it from me, learn from my mistakes, and keep track of your bookkeeping. Thank you for watching.